Hello everyone and welcome to another episode with me. It feels like forever since I made a video, but it's only been 2 weeks, but I've missed you guys. So today I'm going to be talking about, I think, the perfect video for this time of year. I'm going to be talking about lip balms. There are so many lip balms out on the market. Like, how do you pick which lip balm is right for you? How do you know what ingredients in a lip balm is great for your lips and what are bad ingredients that you're wasting your money on? So I'm going to answer all of your questions in regards to lip balms today. So I want everyone, when they are purchasing their lip balm for this time of season, because you're going to notice that your lips are starting to get really dry, they're starting to get flaky, you know, it's an uncomfortable feeling. Sometimes they even crack and bleed, and that's not like, you know, I hate it. It happens to me all of the time. We all are becoming more dehydrated with the winter season ahead. It's getting colder, we're drinking less water. We're getting dehydrated, so instantly you'll notice it is on your lips. So I think when we are buying a lip balm, we tend to gravitate towards the Blistex, the no-name brands, the Burt's Bees, you know, even Vaseline, I think a lot of people use on their lips. Using those products, you really want to make sure that you're reading the ingredients on the back of the product. When you're looking at the ingredient list, you want to make sure that there is at least no wax. Wax is something you never want to have in your lip balm. It's a total faker. So when you put it on your lips, it actually dries out your lips. It instantly feels like your lips are, like, you know, they feel really hydrated, they feel really great, but then you're gonna notice, like, 10 minutes go by, 15 minutes go by, half an hour goes by, you're like, oh, my lips are starting to feel dry again, let me reapply. A lip balm should never make you have to reapply. You should be able to put your lip balm on and hours should be able to go by and that before you're gonna have to reapply again. Because a lip balm should help to retain the moisture. It should help to hydrate the skin and leave the lip like being repaired, right? Instead of being a faker, which a lot of the times waxes or silicones, they're actually fakers on the lip. So when you put your lip balm on, it instantly feels good, but then you're like, oh, I have to reapply. Oh, I have to reapply. Oh, I have to reapply. Oh, where did my chapstick go? And so using a lower end chapstick where wax and silicones are the main ingredient, you're actually doing nothing for your lip. It's just like almost like putting saran wrap over your lip. It's holding all the moisture, and as soon as you take the saran wrap off, it's like bare, it's dry. Everything's been stripped away. So I really don't suggest using lip balms that wax or silicone are the main ingredients in a lip balm. So I'm gonna show you a couple of my favorite lip balms that I've discovered. So first I discovered this one here. It's called Creme de Rose. It is by Dior. It is their lip balm. I liked this one. I've used it for a while. Like, I think this is my third or fourth one that I've gone through. It kind of has it's a very light texture. It's quite creamy. Like, it literally, like, I don't know if you remember, for me when I was younger, my grandmother had roses always around her house, and it reminds me that it definitely had that smell of rose to it. I quite liked it. I mean, it kept the skin hydrated. It is like a rose, like there's rose oil in it, so a natural oil, which is really great to hydrate the lip area. But I mean, like, I give this probably about a 7 out of 10 for a lip balm. Then I discovered the Clarins. It's the Balm Repair, Balm Replenishing Lip Balm with Essential Rose Wax. Now, I did like this one, but again, like, remember what I said about waxes. When I found that this one was more of an instant treatment. When I put it on, it felt really hydrated, but I noticed that after about a half an hour, I would have to reapply it again because it wasn't retaining the moisture. That goes back to what I said with the wax. The wax definitely does. It's a faker on the lip. But then I discovered my all-time favorite lip balm, which I have pretty much one, I think, in every single one of my bags because it works so well. This is the Biotherm... oh my goodness. The Biotherm Smoothing Lip Balm. So the great thing with this is if you are looking at the back on the ingredients, there are no waxes, and there is, I think... glycerin is one of the very end ingredients, so it has a very low percentage of, silicone in it. So it's actually like the main ingredients in the Biotherm lip balm are actually all of the essential oils. I think it has like 5 essential oils in this lip balm. When you put this on, I'm telling you, it's like, I'm gonna put some on right now. It is like heaven on your lips. It has a white texture, it has a slight smell to it, but nothing that's overpowering. But I will put this lip balm on and like 3 hours will go by and I won't even have to put this lip balm on again. It is so hydrating on the lip because the essential oils, they soothe the lip. They hydrate the lip and they don't leave that lip feeling bare. It allows the skin time to repair itself and rehydrate itself so that the skin loses that flakiness, the roughness to the lip area. I love it, especially too, I get really cracky in here in the wintertime, and this is so great for keeping that from happening. I love putting it on before I go to bed because I wake up in the morning and my lips feel really refreshed and plumped. It's also a great underneath your lipstick. If you put this on, lets your lip be really hydrated, and then so you're not getting the crepiness looking in the lipstick area. Anyway guys, these are just a couple of my tricks and my little tips with picking out a lip balm. Really look for lip balms that have essential oils. Look for more natural ingredients and really don't pick a lip balm that is a wax based or a silicone based because you're just wasting your money. Honestly, like this is probably the best $22 I think it cost me that I've ever spent on a lip balm. And let me just tell you, I've had this lip balm for over a year. How many people can say that they have their lip balm that long? I use this every single day, and I think that just goes to show how well the product is, that it's lasted me that long. Anyway guys, thank you for watching my video. If you have any questions at all, please comment below or send me a tweet and I would be happy to tweet you back. Have an amazing day and I look forward to next week. Bye!